So we're having a look at dividends and dividend policy for Ashton Limited. If we look at the profit and loss appropriation account, we find that out of the profit of 50,000, the company is paying 45,000 euro in dividends. And if we look at the balance sheet, we'll see that those dividends are being shared among the ordinary shareholders and the preference shareholders. You'll notice that the preference shareholders have invested 150,000 euro in the company, and they're to earn 7%. So 7% of 150,000 is 10,500. So that means, looking at the ordinary dividend, we have dividends of 45,000, of which preference dividends are 10,500. So the ordinary divs are 34,500. And that 34,500 in ordinary dividend is being shared among 350,000 ordinary shares. That's going to give us an ordinary dividend of 9.86 cent per share. On its own, we can't tell if that's any good. We really have to look at the market price of the share, which, if we look back at the balance sheet, is €1.60. So that leads us to dividend yield, which expresses the dividend per share, 9.86 cent, as a percentage of the market price of the share. And that gives us a dividend yield of 6.16%. That's considerably higher than the return you get on risk-free investments. But we'll notice later that it's down on last year's dividend figure. So a dividend on its own, as an amount of money like 9.86 cent, doesn't mean much really, unless you compare it with last year's dividend per share. You really do have to express it as a percentage of how much the shares are worth, which would be the current market price. And that's your dividend yield. Next, we should look at the ability of the company's profits to cover the dividend. Dividend cover. We remember that our net profit was 50,000. But we remember also that the preference dividend was 10,500. So the net profit attributable to ordinary shareholders was only 39,500. And we gave them dividend of 34,500. So that gives us a dividend cover of a very low 1.14 times. The net profit attributable to ordinary shareholders, 39,500, it's only 1.14 times the actual dividends that we gave out to them. This company has a very low dividend cover, and it means that it only maintained its dividend at the expense of giving out almost all of the available profits.
Which isn't good.